tonight is to have fun. And so I hope you will enjoy the music, enjoy the food during intermission if you haven't already done so, and enjoy the stories too. There's also, if you haven't already discovered, the silent auction in Reese Hall. And the silent auction will end, bidding will end at the end of intermission. So make sure you get your bids in, and I'll announce all the winners at the end of the concert. So the music tonight comes from all different places, and they're all places that I've been to or that I'm going to. In the case of the first set of songs that's coming up, this is a place where I will be going, and actually all of the proceeds from tonight's event will help me to get there. I'll be doing my next pilgrimage journey to Ireland in June and July. And so everything that is raised tonight will help me to get there and help support my way on the pilgrimage route on the Wicklow Way in Ireland. And I have been invited to go with Vox Peregrini, which is a choral group that pilgrims the Wicklow Way in Ireland every other year. And so I will be with 19 other people journeying together, and we will be singing all along the way. I am told that I will get my music by the end of next week, and I'm really excited because I will have finished with this music. But I really do hope that you will enjoy this time that we'll have together and just have fun. I will promise you I won't get all the words right, but we're going to have fun and enjoy this time together, and I'm just so glad you are here. Thank you for being here.
Oh, tell
So one of my first experiences traveling abroad was a trip with 200 plus high school students. I was one of those high school students. I went with the Arizona Ambassadors of Music the summer after my senior year of high school, and we did 7 countries in Europe in about 16 days. Let's see if I can remember the countries. We started in England, France, and then in some order we went to Austria, Switzerland. We drove through Liechtenstein and stopped to have lunch, and spent a day in Venice, Italy, and then we flew out of Germany. And it was amazing, and it kind of awoken this spirit of travel for me. And this group of high school students, we were band and choir students, and I was in the choir, and we got to sing in the most incredible places. And I wept with the news about Notre Dame last week. I didn't have the chance to sing there, but we visited there on this trip, this tour throughout Europe, and it reminded me of all the places we did get to sing, and all of these beautiful cathedrals and basilicas and so many wonderful places, and it set this fire within me that I wanted to see new places and to meet new people, and I'm so grateful for my parents, who were sitting in the back. I'm so grateful for my parents who supported me through that trip, which has been an amazing journey as I've traveled now to several different places around the world. And I'm so grateful for that. The next set of pieces, they are in the French language, and I have to tell you, France wasn't my favorite place when I went to go there. And I think part of the reason was the organizers and the people who were feeding us in France, they thought it would be great for us to just have American food. So I remember, like, every open moment we had and we were allowed to go out on our own, I was like, French pastries. Because they were like serving us chicken fried steak for dinner, and I'm like, oh, that's so sad. But for these next two French pieces, they are what's the word I'm looking for? They're more lyrical in nature, and I invite you to hold your applause till after both pieces are done, because we won't take a break in between in terms of mood and space. And so I hope you enjoy.
I
was taking a month to walk across northern Spain. And it was so amazing. Back in October of 2017, I walked the majority of the Camino de Santiago from Pamplona, Spain, to Santiago, and then I went down to Finisterre on the coach. On the coast, the word I'm looking for, the coast. Finisterre was believed to be the end of the world before they knew that it wasn't. And then I went up north to Muxia and spent my last couple of days in Spain there before flying out of Madrid. And one of the most amazing things about being on the Camino de Santiago was the relationships that you formed with complete strangers. And because you didn't know how long you would be in relationship with somebody on the Camino, you formed deep relationships fast. There was no talking about the weather. There was really no, you know, saying your name even, or where you're from. It was more, why are you here? What are you doing on this journey, and why is it so important to you? And we had amazing time of relationship and eating, and it was so fleeting, yet so steadfast. It was this beautiful time, and I truly cannot wait to go on this pilgrimage in Ireland in June to travel with people this time and be able to build those relationships even further. One of the funny stories of Spain, it was my first day of walking. And I'll back up. If you don't know me very well, you should know that I'm kind of clumsy. And one of the things that was a recurring conversation at the dinner table was when I was a child was, what owie did I get that day? I always came home with something. So on the first day of the Camino, you can see where this is going. I was walking along with my new friend, Florian, and we're still friends, in fact. All of a sudden, we were talking about houses and what kind of house we each individually would want to build if we could ever build a house. And we just walk, and all of a sudden, I'm like, ow! And I ran into a mailbox. And I looked at it, and I looked at Florian, and I said, that's going to leave a scar. And sure enough, it's right there. There's my scar from Spain. I have a scar from playing basketball in a dress, and, you know. So even in Spain, I'm still quite clumsy, and